We've covered a lot in our recent workshop videos, with many more to come. It can be easy to forget some really useful tips. So in this video, we'll be taking a look at some of the top tips we've covered so far. Let's start with the basics, introducing ourselves and the service team.
We want the customer to feel completely relaxed at the prospect of coming to visit us. The more relaxed they are, the more positive the experience, and the more positive the experience, the more likely they are to return or to recommend us to others. Think about it from the customer's point of view. 2 to 3 days prior to their appointment, the customer receives a video. Hi, Mr. Smith, I'm Paul, your service advisor at CNow. Really looking forward to meeting you at 2 p.m. on Friday for your first vehicle service. We're located just off Molly Miller's Lane, and as you drive into our dealership, parking is situated just here. Please ensure you bring your service logbook. How easy was that? In a matter of seconds, we're providing the customer with a personalised video that includes a friendly introduction to us and the dealership. Sending this really simple, really short video 2 to 3 days prior also serves as a reminder. And with See It Now, we'll even know when the customer has watched the video.
Now our customer has had a warm introduction to the team and dropped their vehicle off, let's take a look at the equipment we can use in the workshop to deliver clear and concise information to them.
Now, the workshop can be a noisy place, and we need to make sure the customer can hear what we're saying. So, we need a mic. Ah, yes, the iRig microphone, again provided by See It Now, reduces background noise. Impressive. So this is really important. The iRig mics are one directional, apparently. So we need to make sure the side with the iRig logo is facing us. This will mean that we get the best possible audio. Using a laser pointer is handy too. This allows us to point out areas of concern and can be extremely beneficial with helping the customer understand where on the vehicle we're referring to. We should always ensure we measure the tread using a digital tyre tread gauge. These are best to show on video as it's easy for the customer to read. When showing the customer the wear on their brake pads, best practice would be to reference what the pads are when new. We can then draw into the shot the actual pad measurements as they stand now. This is a simple and helpful visual aid, which shows the customer exactly how much the pads are worn. Moving on to disc thickness, we need to measure one disc per axle set before giving the customer the measurement. We also need to explain to them the condition of the disc, whether it be lipped, scored, cracked or corroded. At this point, it's always helpful to explain to the customer the minimum discard thickness. This way, they'll know how close the disc is to needing replacing.
Great. Now we've worked out the type of equipment we can use and how to use it to the benefit of the customer, let's take a look at how we can further enhance the customer experience.
While we're under the vehicle, we should show the sump, gearbox, drive shaft and suspension. At this point, if necessary, we can highlight to the customer anything that might be an issue. If there's a leak somewhere, for example, this can be pointed out. As we continue to go through, we check the exhaust to make sure it's all secure and there's no damage. We also need to check the brake and fuel lines. It's always worth explaining to the customer what these are and that they're okay. When we reach the back of the vehicle, we'll check the rear box again to make sure it's secure and there's no damage or corrosion. Once we've done that, we move to the offside rear to check the tyres, brakes and suspension. We'd finish the video as we started it, but this time at the rear of the car and displaying the rear number plate. We provide some next steps, which ensure that the customer knows exactly what's going to happen with a call to action. This will usually be a service advisor contacting them shortly. It's always important to summarise the work if there is any required on the vehicle. We thank them for choosing our dealership and also for watching the video. Remember, we need to ask the customer to rate the video. As soon as we send a See It Now video, we can track its status and be notified when the customer's watched it. But not just that, it also means that we've delivered a great and memorable experience for our customers. There's nothing worse than putting time and effort into a video that nobody then watches. So, what's the reason that nobody's watching? There are a few questions that we need to ask ourselves. The main ones being, do our customers know that they're going to get a video? And have we got the all-important contact information? The good news is, there's a really easy way to remedy this. We can't force people to watch, but we can make it as easy as possible for them to remember. How the customer receives the info is incredibly important. In a world of smart devices, although we can check email at the touch of a button, we sometimes have to do just that, touch a button. SMS, however, is much more immediate. Most people's phones will be set up to receive a notification if an SMS message comes through. We need to use this to our advantage. Ensuring that we have SMS enabled on our CNow app can halve the time it takes for the customer to watch the video. If there's a car in the workshop that's awaiting the all-important approval, it's best to phone the customer within 20 to 30 minutes of having sent the video. This can act as a gentle reminder. The benefits to us as the service team are huge. This can save us countless hours having to explain work identified on a vehicle over the phone or in person, and the customer can watch the video as many times as they like.
We hope that watching this summary video has brought together some useful and helpful tips that can be used every day to help with delivering a great customer experience and adding value to your business. Look forward to seeing you on the next video.